Hello everybody, welcome to today's episode. We are at the lovely Monk Lakes on Lake 3 on peg 125. And today we're going to be looking at paste fishing. So we're going to start off short, work our way out to like 13, 14 meters, and then hopefully we'll end up fishing down the edge, catching some big boys. Hopefully you'll pick up some hints and tips along the way. Got a few little things to show you guys that can help you get your head around paste fishing, and also, you know, put a few more fish in the net at the end of the day in match situations. So hopefully you enjoy it, and catch up with you shortly. Right, the bait for today, obviously, as we run through earlier, we're going to be fishing paste and more paste. So just going to run you through what paste I use and a couple of little tips on how to adapt the paste to get it right for the hook. And, you know, a couple of little tips on how you can adapt your bait as you go through during the day, just to make it right for the hook and for the fishing conditions. So the paste we're going to use is the Pro Paste in original and the Pro Paste Red. They do also do a green version, but what I'm going to use is a little bit of the Pro Green fish meal in with my original, and that just gives it a slight green tint. I like to always measure out my paste. So basically we want one pot of the original Pro Paste, if we can get it in there. One pot, then we're going to go one pot of the Pro Green fish meal. This is a really fine kind of sticky ground bait, and because the original paste, it can be really sticky, this takes a little bit of the stickiness away from it, just makes it a bit more easier to handle when you're fishing with it. So one pot of that, and then for every pot of paste you want about one pot of water. So let's just go one, two, and then we just give that a really good mix. It's going to look and feel like soup, and you're going to think that's going to be no good to man nor beast. But don't worry about it. Make sure you get all the bits in the corner. And once that's had a good mix, you'll see it's literally dripping. But give it half an hour and that'll be there or thereabouts. Then also, we're going to use some red today. We're going to use this in the edge. What that does, it gives you a really good standout bait when you're fishing over a big pile of ground bait. Literally just going to use this straight out the bag, but again, if you want to mix something with it, the meaty salmon ground bait would be a really good ground bait to mix 50-50 again, if you like that consistency that we've got with the other paste. So again, one pot, and then not quite as much on this one. I'd say that's just over 3/4 full, that pot. There we go. And the paste preparation really is that simple. Again, we'll leave that until we're ready to start fishing, and that'll be there or thereabouts. The only other bait for today, 4mm fin feeds, 6mm fin feeds, and you're ready to go. I keep my paste rigs really, really simple. There's no reason to overcomplicate them. Paste fishing can sometimes give you enough headaches as it is. So all my three rigs are really simple. My short rig and my long rig are identical. 15 DuraSlip elastic, 019 Powerline mainline, an 017 XSHB ready tied hook length. Now the shotting for these is really simple. Again, I use a tiny little float stop and an inline Olivet. Now what the inline Olivet does is when you put your paste in the pot, The inline Olivet drops down and sits nicely below the float, and it gives it an anchor. So when you're shipping out, the rig's swinging, doesn't get any tangles. That's the main thing. As I say, long rig and short rig, both exactly the same. And on these, I just use the new Preston paste pots, perfect size for a big ball of paste and some pellets in there. The difference in the edge rig is, again, 019 power line, main line, 017 and a 10 XSHB for the hook. I used the size one float, but I just used two stots underneath the float. And basically I'm using the paste as an anchor. You know, just want the paste to be a big blob and go to the bottom. Obviously they're big fish in here. We've got a bit of a snag up the edge there. So I've beefed up to a 19 DuraSlip elastic for that. And then the pot is the XL pot. I like to use this because I can get a nice big blob of paste in there. Then also I can cap it off with a decent amount of ground bait, which gives those big fish something to home in on. Hopefully your paste is sitting on top when they come in to waffle it all up. So that's the rigs for today. Nice and simple, don't overcomplicate them, and you'll be fine. Just started the session now, and we're literally just gonna feed a ball of paste and 8 4 mils and 8 6 mil pellets, and we're just gonna start on this short line, plop that in there. Now, one important thing to remember when you're paste fishing is that your pole float, or your pole pot, is always a bit further back from the end of your float. So it's a good idea to mark out just how far the pole pot is back from where you've plumbed up. And then you can make sure you're always fishing on the right spot. And I also like to shot my float with the paste. As you can see, it's just slightly a bit low there. But what this enables you to do is, when you get a few fish in your peg and they dig up the bottom, your float starts going under all the time, and you know you need to have another little replumb, or it's time to move spots. So hopefully this will shoot straight under for us and start putting some fish in the net. Oh, there's a bite there. So same again. Same size bit of paste. Not really had enough bites yet to start working stuff out, but once you start getting a few bites, you can start playing around with the size bit of paste you want to put on the hook. Bigger, smaller. How many pellets you're going to feed. But just to start, just stick to plan A. And see what we can catch. Also, what I do when I'm lowering my rigging, I just hold the float about that far out of the water as everything settles. And quite often you can feel the sliding Olivet hit the rubber, and you can almost just lower your rig to the bottom to settle the tip with the weight of the paste. And then you always know you're fishing right on the bottom. Just getting an odd blow coming up, which is always a good sign. Just gonna trickle in 6 pellets of loose fed as well. Just try and draw some fish into the peg to start with. You should find, once you get a few bites on this, probably get some bubbles and bits and pieces, and that's always a good sign. Another important little tip to remember is, when you're using the sliding Olivet, You want to make sure that it doesn't completely cock the float, because obviously when your paste falls off, you want to know that your paste has fallen off. So if you use a slightly smaller Olivet than is required, then when your paste does come off, your float will pop up and you'll know you're not fishing. Don't know if you can quite see on the camera, but at some point you will. Another great tip is a bowl of water when you're paste fishing. If you just dip your fingers in before and after you've baited up with your paste, you find at the end of the day you're not a big sticky ball of paste, which is always nice. What I do with mine as well is I have a towel dipped in it and I just cover half the bait box that I've got my paste over. So I literally just got a little bit where I can get a ball of paste out easily. Just helps prevent the sun from wrecking the rest of the paste that you've already got knocked up as well. Another inquiry then, little liner. What we're looking for is that sharp, straight underbite. Oh, missed him. Let's adjust that float a little bit. Only needs to be a little bit. Remember, you're just adjusting it so you've got a little bit more tip showing. So you don't need to move it inches and inches. There you go, that's a bit better. What we do is we'll have one more go and then we'll try putting a tiny little ball of paste on, seeing if we can get a bite. Sometimes you put a little ball of paste on and you catch a skimmer. It kind of tells you that there's skimmers there rather than carp. And then it's time to rethink and move spots or start another line. There you go. As predicted, there's a big skimmer there. Not exactly the proposed target, but what we can do is we're just going to go another section further out and start again. Yeah, basically the same depth. So same again, we're not going to go mad or change anything too drastically. Great thing about that sliding Olivet is it just eliminates any tangles when you're shipping out with the paste, because it always gives you an anchor point. good start short, probably caught 7 or 8 good carp. Started to die off. It was getting lots of bubbles there. And to be honest, I think they were skimmers. We caught 2 or 3 skimmers and a little tench. And sort of lots of bubbles, but not really many bites. So it's time to move out onto the long line. We've literally just started exactly how we did on the short line, a ball of paste with a few pellets. And literally within 2 minutes, we've caught one on this, which is this one here. Again, nice little crazy common. On this long line, I just like to loose feed a few 4 mil pellets. It pulls some fish into the peg. Just gonna adjust that float ever so slightly. As usual, my paste has fallen out. So same again, when we ship out, firstly you want to make sure your pole's together. When we ship out again, you just need to remember that paste pot's not exactly on the end of your pole, so you need to make sure you go past your mark a little bit. Dip your paste in and then just bring your tip back over where that paste dropped in. Then hold everything tight and just lower that onto the bottom. Got indications on this straight away, some bubbles and a liner. Big liner then, straight off. This is where it becomes important to make sure you're striking at the right bites, because what you don't want to be doing is shipping in and out at 13 meters for a missed bite. So you want to be patient, you want to make sure you're striking at the right bites. You want those real positive jabs under. Even sometimes when you're fishing the long pole, it's worth going just a little bit more over depth, almost so you've got the whole tip of the float out, just to make sure that you are striking at a proper bite. There's one there, look. Fishing nice strong tackle, so there's no need to worry too much about when they tear off. Bit bigger this one. Looks like a decent mirror, this one. Another big common. He's not going to give up easily. Here he comes. If he'll let me hold him up. There you go. Nice big paste eating common carp. Let's get him back. So the long line's been brilliant today. Potting in a few pellets with a blob of paste and then loose feeding 4mm thin perfect pellets over the top. It's been literally one a drop. Time of day now, we're gonna put some bait in down the edge. I did mix up a bag of chunky fish earlier. I got it really on the wet side. It's quite deep in the edge here. So you want it to sort of go to the bottom and kind of stay there as much as possible. So I'm gonna start off by feeding 3 pots. Quite positive, but they're big old fish in here, so they'll soon mop that up. We'll soon be feeding some more bait down there. So we're just gonna sandcastle him in as much as possible. There's one. Last one. Three. So gonna give that 10 minutes, catch 2 or 3 more on the long pole, and then see if we can catch some big boys in the edge. So we caught another 2 or 3 fish on the long pole line, and we just come down in the edge. And I think I've had 4 drop-ins and put probably 50 pound in the net. All we're doing now, we've got the big XL pot on, and we're just putting a nice big blob of ground bait in there and nice bit of red paste over the top, and just literally sitting here and waiting for it to go under, and it's been a bit good. Got a liner there now. Oh, another liner. Probably doesn't help, Zolt's just got in the lake. But there you go. Not taking any prisoners on this line. Got 019, 19 Dura slip elastic. Still a size 10 hook. But as you can see, when this one pops up, they're a bit on the large size, these edge fish. Where is he? Can't believe how good the fishing's been today. It's literally been pretty much a bite every drop in on pretty much anything we've done. And these ones are just topping it off. Oh, there he goes. I've lost my mic. Are the ones that you want. I won't attempt to lift him out because he'll bound to do a somersault back into the lake. Bit of red paste. One little thing I am doing with the ground bait, because it's quite deep, I am squeezing it into a little bit of a ball rather than potting it in loose. Just helps it get to the bottom and concentrate everything a little bit on the bottom a bit more. The only thing it does do is it squashes your paste in the pot a little bit, so sometimes it's hard to rattle out the pot. There it goes. Hold everything straight again. There we go. Indication straight away. Certainly if this was a match today, we'd take some beating, that's for sure. Just trying to get around Zolt's camera at the moment. It's not ideal. Now the monk's double. Well, we're gonna draw the session to a close for today. It's been a really good day here. Fishing's been unbelievable, to be honest. Started off on the short pole and caught, not loads, but enough to keep you ticking over for the first couple of hours. Then we went on to the long pole and that was really, really good. It was a biter chuck, loose feeding pellets, and just brought loads of fish into your peg. It was really good on the long pole. And then we finished up fishing in the edge here, where it's been literally, again, a bite every drop in. Just missed a bite there. But when you get a bite down this edge, they've all been great big ones. It's been quite good fun. Just same again, blob of paste, red paste this time, fishing in the edge. I think it just gives you a really good standout bait over your ground bait. And what I have done is, instead of feeding ground bait loose, because it's quite deep there, just been squeezing it into a bit of a ball. There he is. Probably the smallest edge fish of the day, that one. About right. Anyway, guys, if you like the video, don't forget to like and subscribe to Preston Innovations Facebook and YouTube pages. And we'll see you all soon.